during this moment for the time to put down this cameraman. All of us who have become backsliders, but they help to transmit the gospel, and it's awesome and it's great. Put your hands together for the Lord again. Please, you can take your seat. When I turned, I saw Pastor Nicky here, all the way from there, but he didn't tell me he was coming. Wow, my son. Please, let's welcome Pastor Nicky, all the way from Tennessee, sorry, Tennessee. He did a great work. But now, this week, our team for the conference is God is able to do far more. Turn to somebody and say, God is able to do far more. And one of the names of God is Jehovah Overdue. Now, you see, your understanding about everything makes you outstanding. And anything you don't understand will stand on you. So the way you see God is the way he manifests to you. That is why in the olden days, anytime he appears, he comes with a different name. Many have not talked. Why? Because see, the different names of God manifest the different nature of God. So when Moses saw him, he said, when the people ask me, what is your name? He said, tell them, I am everything. But from time to time, I manifest in different areas. So God is called Jehovah Overdue, because every limit you set for him, he will break it. He is a limit breaker. And once he is a limit breaker, all his children are also limit breakers. So I want you to know, in case anybody has categorized you and put you within certain category, after this conference, you are breaking that limit and you are going to do some, God is going to do some marvelous things in your life. How does things that are impossible for human mind and things that are illogical to the educated become common for God? Because he is the God of miracles. Now, in Deuteronomy 32, verse 230, the Bible says, one will chase 1,000 and two will chase 10,000. What kind of arithmetic is that? Except by Jehovah Overdue. Sometimes he does things that are impossible for human mind. And so sometimes many educated people struggle to understand some of the things that God has, because they are not logical. But remember, God is not like any other human being. He is the God of all possibility. There is nothing too hard for him. We call him the impossibility specialist. Last week we were doing some little breakfast and then a woman had had PAMS for 14 years. I don't know if you know what is PAMS. You know it. The Ghana people call it coco. And some tumors that come under your anus and then you begin to bleed and bleed and bleed. And the woman has used all kinds of medicine to help her. So she mistakenly found herself in the toilet. And the lights went off, because where I come from, light goes off from time to time. So she was just trying to find some paper to help herself. And her hands touched one paper. Because of the light, he didn't check. It was a church flyer. The flyer we used to go on so well. So she used it to scratch her buttocks. The 40-year path disappeared. Clap your hands, maybe you are here. You don't understand what I'm saying. The 40-year disease that the woman had tried all kinds of medicine, the flyer that they have written, Jesus loves you, turn it off one touch. This is why you can't put God in any test tube. You can't put God in a benzene burner. You can't put God, you can't analyze him, you cannot calculate him. So when it seems like everything is quiet, ladies and gentlemen, I have good news for you. That is when God is about to show up in your life and do something incredible and do something impossible. You know, it's a very funny testimony, but if you were the one who was sick for 40 years, you don't care what will heal you. All you need is healing. And so, what we are talking about, he is able to do far more. These are some of the things that he does that doesn't make sense. But whether you believe it or you don't believe it, the one that received the miracle is relieved of 40 years of going through torture and trouble. A young lady came to church. She's called Barry Kissy. She's a Muslim. And she had SS black genotype. Because of that, he couldn't even take part in the Muslim Ramadan. And they were not supposed to go to church, but because she came from one of the villages and came to Accra, now that she's in Accra, she has become a free range chicken, so she can go anywhere. So somebody invited her to church. She came and they heard us announcing fasting. They said, I've never fasted. Even with the Muslim one, I cannot fast. But I'm going to try this one. So we went because that's one of the ways to trigger the miracles. Went through this fasting, we finished. And then the parents heard that she has stopped going to the mosque. So they stopped paying her school fees. So I took it over and I sponsored her. But when she finished school, she got a job with one of the mining companies. They did some few months of them. They said, we are not going to take you people and make you rare workers. So everybody is supposed to do a blood test. And the lady knew that if they find out that she's SS, they are not going to pay her. But she has forgotten that when she left the mosque to the church, she has come to meet Jehovah overdue. Yeah. So we called everybody from the office, tested everybody. She was shivering. The next day she came to work, and the boss called her and said, Marie, come here, say, everybody's report has come. She knew what was going to be the outcome. But she didn't know that God can bypass protocol and do miracles. When they put her report and they place it there, SS 10 to AA, the blood genotype has checked from SS to AA. This is what our God can do. So don't sit in church with an impossibility mentality. That's why I tell people, why will you be in church and be sad? Because I don't understand why you should be sad. Even in death, we are winning. When we are alive, we are winners. When we die, we are winners. When we grow up, we are winners. When we come down, we are winners. So as a believer, because we are serving Jehovah over you, we are always winning from glory to glory to glory to glory to glory. I don't know the last time God visited you, but this week he told me to tell you, he will visit you once again. So, Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20. Faith cometh by hearing. And hearing by the word. So we go to our anchor scripture to begin our conference today. Ephesians chapter 3. Now, to him, who is able to do? He has the ability to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or imagine. He does not only do what you ask, even what you are thinking, according to his power, not the power of your landlord, not the power of your daughter, not the power of your government, not the power of who is present and who is absent. According to his power that is at work within us. That is why the Christian that is full of faith is indestructible, because there is something working in the inside manifesting on the outside. He is able to do. So number one, fix your eye on the power of God. Anytime we are talking about God is able to do, don't look at yourself, because it will destroy your faith. When you look at yourself, you may say, where do I come from? York City. One day I traveled when I was a boy, the Lord said to me, go and tell the church people that I am about to do strange miracles. So I came, it was a Friday evening, and I said, God is going to do some strange miracles here. Nobody knows what it was. There was this gentleman that went home after the church service. He said, "Say, look at." When he got home, she passed through the living room and then smelled grandma's soup in the room. Meanwhile, she lives at home. Nobody has cooked the soup. But grandma's soup is the best soup that ever lives. You know, when you smell your desire, you can feel it. So you began to send everywhere in the room and go to the dining table, sitting there in the room, and you saw that somebody has cooked grandma's soup with yam dogs and mutu and arranged it like a woman in the house. Put the towel, water, everything. And somebody says, I have only two kids. One is in my wardrobe, one is in my pocket. Who came here to cook grandma's soup? He ran out of the house and called somebody in the church and he said, "Let this is what I've come to find out." They said, "Don't forget the pastor said today we will see three things." So this guy went to the bar and began to pray for 1 hour before he could come and consume the grandma's soup and the special one. Now, whilst eating, he saw something small written there in Greek. So when they used Google to translate, it was written angelic visitation. Now, it was Saturday, and Saturday is my phone is off. At 2 a.m., I saw this gentleman taking the picture of the food, the soup and everything, and he sent it to me. So I called him 2 a.m. I said, "Where is the rest of the soup?" He said, "I've eaten it by a little bit." I said, "Don't touch it, bring it to church. We are going to university. We are going to school." Sometimes you might want to share your papers. What is he talking about? You and you keep quiet and listen. Because when some of you have complex problems and God is going to use a strange miracle, something that human beings cannot understand, to solve that problem for you, because God is able to do a seemingly abundantly above all that you can think and imagine. So, Apostle, unfortunately, he didn't come to church. While he came, I was already preaching. And that day, the manager of Coca-Cola Company has visited the church. He's a white man and his wife. So when I saw him, I said, "Where is the soup?" He said, "It's here." He gave me the recipe just a little. And I said, so I told the people in the church, I said, "If this soup is truly angelic, everybody who is sick, come here." Some people with stubborn faith came forward. But I tasted the soup first. In case there is anything, let it get me first. And then I started putting just a little in the palm of those who came by faith. Look at what happened. Somebody had rheumatism for 15 years. He just licked the thing and felt that, and the rheumatism disappeared. Then there was another lady from Nigeria who has come to church. Her problem is inability to go to the toilet. She cannot go to the toilet until she is induced. And it has persisted for 10 years. And while she came to church that day, it has been 3 weeks since she went to the toilet. That's why some of you will know that how you keep long at the toilet is a blessing, but you don't know. They have operated on her, washed her tooth, and yet, natural toilet won't flow. So this lady came, tested this one I call angelic soup. Instantly, he started going back and forth in there. And the usher said, "Sinner, sinner." He said, "I can't see that. You don't know what is happening to me." And volcano action began in her stomach. She went to toilet 3 times that Sunday morning before we closed church. And he said, "Pastor, I wanted you to finish and close early because I wanted to go and continue this miraculous job that the Lord has done in my life." God broke that 10 years. Faith. And we thought that was all, because many people are unique today. They are still like you. Sometimes I ask you, when you quote that scripture, "When God, all things are possible," what do you mean? Which areas are possible and which areas are impossible? The limits we have placed on our lives are in our mind. God can go as far as your mind can take. And it is mentality that defines destiny. Mentality. God is bigger than America. He's bigger than Africa. So don't think like an American. Don't think like an African. Don't think like an educated man. Think like a believer of the Bible. Many things in the Bible don't make sense. And so, the miracle has not ended. There is this boy called Alhassan, who is a Muslim. He has never been to church in his life. Why is he in Accra? He has gotten a new admission to go to nursing school. And somebody said, go to Accra and do some small work. You'll get money to come back and pay. So he came to Accra, sleeping outside. And because the church is in the middle of the city, somebody said, don't go to that church, maybe you'll help. So Ibrahim has come to church for the first time, sitting at the back. So when he heard the testimonies, he came forward. Why did he come forward? Not for him. His mother has been paralyzed for 22 years. The boy himself is, the mother has been paralyzed for 21 years. When this boy was in the mother's room, the mother stepped on medicine and got paralyzed. So all Ibrahim's life, they have never seen the mother walking. So he came forward, never been to church. And he said, man of God, you pray, we see. So after the second, he told the mother, he said, Aja, I think something is going to happen to you. Aja said, Ibrahim, have you gone to a crowd to see a more powerful Baba than the ones we have here? He said, Aja, I don't know, but I know something is going to happen. Sunday, Friday afternoon, Aja returned from the mosque. And he was sleeping and he had a vision. He said, I saw your pastor in white suit. And he said, Adia, stand up. And I heard hands. Adia stood up, having not walked for 21 years and is still walking up today. How will God be? By something that many people will doubt. But you see, we are talking about God who is able to do far more. Far more. So in your life, what do you think can be quantified as far more? Listen to me, our problem is, this is what I'm going to deal with. It's not what I want to do. As for that matter, I said it. But what we have to deal with it, what do we do for him to do? That's the biggest problem of the church. Nobody yet have miracles. Miracles are rare. We've seen miracles. Everybody that has a Bible believes in the miracle because the Bible begins with the miracles and ends with the miracle.
Amen.
But I'm pressing it. He did it for them. Why would he do it in our life? What did they do? What can we do? That's the biggest problem. Is not that people doubt God or whatever. They don't know what to do to connect to the ground. Now listen to another testimony. I was there when somebody called me. And the person is calling from Nigeria. What is happening? It was in the evening. He lived in a compound house. You move from this one school, you go here, you go here, you go here, you go here. And then Amrobes came to the house. Now when they came, they were doing room service. Meaning that when we finish with room one, we go to room two. So the people in room seven know that they are in room three. They are holding guns, they are standing at the gate. Now this guy, we've been convincing him to come to church and he won't come. So he was in room five. So he made a different call and said, tell Pastor to pray for me, the people are here. I said, do you know this? I believe. When fire is at your background. So I prayed a simple prayer and said, Lord, for this guy's salvation, do something incredible. And I didn't know what God was going to do. But look at what he can do more far. Jehovah over you. I'm going to finish room one, room two, room five. They came to room five. When they entered into the room, his two children were sleeping on the floor. The guy has no carpet. So they look at one. They look at Oga. What do you know your room in basa basa like this? No carpet, no television. Okay, you know, this is what the money we stole tonight. Take it. Use it. Buy TV. Buy carpet. They'll create your room. We will see you next time. God wanted to sow a seed. Are we talking about the God of the impossible? There is a church. We are not defending God. We are just telling this is how He is. So change your mind. The doctor said what? What did Jesus say? The Bible said Jesus healed all manner of sicknesses and all manner of diseases. All manner. In the hospital, it's not all manner. We get to a place ahead here, you cannot go far. But God is able to do far more. 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 Now, last week, we were having some breakfast and then one of my singers. And because we were in church every day, couldn't get time to do a lot of studies. Now they had an exam the next day. The church closes at 9:30, he goes home, he opens his computer. Jesus, am I failing tomorrow? And the church is on time, all the questions and answers were there for him. Like, it's not a problem. If it's a problem, everybody will get it. He's the only one. He called me at 2 a.m. Papa. Jesus, I'm going to read your question and answer. Children are well born. Unless I use it, begin to write. God is more powerful than God is. Another lady was trying to come to church during this COVID, something, and then they have, you know, COVID have brought classroom on the computer. So they were trying to open a portal to answer some questions.